Excellent. Hello, everybody. And first of all, Yusuf, congratulations on such a very stimulating and fascinating session composed of some wonderful, wonderful speakers. I've learned a lot. Really, just by way of sharing some of my thinking going into this meeting and indeed going into the overall summit that we're organizing these weeks. But it's something which I just will be familiar to people, but I just want to reiterate it and encourage people to think. And that is the importance of the enabling regulatory environment. Now, to state something, terribly obvious, you will know that data is science is enabled through data, and that's called variously, science enabled data and all the rest of it. Now, what is not as pronounced in terms of awareness and in terms of discussion is the impact of regulation on this data upon which science is enabled. So just breaking that down a little bit, you will probably be familiar with the European Union's data protection regulation, the GDPR, the General Data Protection Regulation. Now, clearly, we this session is not designed to focus too much on regulation, and there would never be enough time. However, I would just like people maybe to develop an awareness of these issues in general. So, but looking at the GDPR in particular, this is an omnibus piece of legislation. So it impacts data, personal data for whichever use. But the point I want to highlight here is that the regulation has extraterritorial application. And what that means, as you know, is it effectively applies everywhere. Now, and again, that is a simplification, and there's rules and regulations, all the rest of it. But essentially, so for the sake of this conversation, it's impacting on your science, you see? And I think it's hugely important that you take that knowledge and awareness of that fact, and you try to understand what it means in terms of the science you're doing, but also it's going to inform the partnerships and collaborations that you will want to form, that others will want to form with you in the future. And of course, you have Horizon Europe, but let's not just have a European bias here. I think it's very important that the general impact of this regulation is hugely important. And what it does is, it does impact the transfer of data, for example, between Europe and Africa and between Africa and Europe and between Europe and the United States and the United States and Europe, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. So, of course, it's going to impact in ways you probably don't understand yet, but I think it's vitally important to try and understand that. So my observations there would be, try not to be passive about this. I think it does need you to go forward and try and figure out what it means. And various people here today have spoken about their research strategies and white papers, which is very, very good. But these papers and these reflections need to understand the omnibus nature of data protection regulation. And of course, I've referenced the GDPR there, but also there's new regulations evolving in the United States of America. You've got a federal level data protection regulation. You've got state, California already has theirs in place. You've got emerging regulation in India and Japan, and some of these have relationships with the European Union and some don't. But I think it's an important, very, very important impact to understand on science, because it, on the one hand, it potentially is a barrier to the activities you want to undertake in terms of at a practical level, making partnerships or collaborations difficult. But at a more advanced opportunity level, it then will allow you, through working and being regulatory compliant, and I'm not saying regulatory compliant with the European Union, I'm just talking about regulatory compliant with your own regulations and how those regulations relate to other regulations. But I think understanding that environment will allow you to take advantage of the opportunity to advance and use the data, to do science with the data, and to evolve and go towards innovation with the data and do the things you need to do with data in order to do that. And of course, this has particular relevance in the area of health, but not only, because we're now seeing health data transported via satellites. So therefore, you know, the whole area of space becomes pertinent to regulation. And the German courts last year ruled that information on energy consumption is personal data. So that's just, in my view, a bizarre, but just a factual example. So how this works in future and informs your environment of a scientist's is hugely important, but the responsibility is on you to find out how it all works and what it means. And I've spoken about the data protection regulation, but there are many others. And again, in the area of health, there's a forthcoming regulation on in vitro diagnostics. And again, it will have global applicability. There's regulations in clinical trials. There's a new regulation on medical devices in the health space. And then outside there, you've got various biotechnology regulations. And then the European Union is coming forward with a whole raft of digital transition regulations, which are, yes, they're enabling the digital economy, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera, but they have impacts on health and other areas. So that's really just what I wanted to sensitize people to here today. So I think as you embark on your dialogue and you advance to share knowledge, and as you advance in your engagement with strategic partners around the world, that this issue of regulation is going to be an increasingly important aspect of the dialogue. And as I said, there's the negative. You don't want it to impact negatively on what you do and told, oh, well, you can't be our partner because, or we can't share data with you, or we can't accept your data, or whatever. They're the negatives. But as I said, there are positives. And I think being able to advance this is going to enable that. So I think just all round, I think it's hugely, hugely important. And then the other thing I just wanted to highlight, and you've spoken eloquently about research infrastructures and capacity building. And again, that's vital to extend, and certainly is a topic where in particular the General Assembly and the United Nations, particularly with reference to the SDGs, need to be much more advanced, and I think take greater context and of the existing knowledge and know-how contained in the work that you're doing, and being able to support that further. And you're wondering about support, and of course, a lot of people wonder, where's the money going to come from? That's of course always the question. But I'm learning a lot recently about development finance, and development finance is the money that comes from the World Bank and the IMF and the European Investment Bank, and there's a host of others. And increasingly, I'm beginning to see the narrative and policy objectives of these development finance bodies becoming more articulate in terms of innovation. So I think that should be part of your thinking going forward in seeing how these bodies can support what you want to do. And I suppose the final point I'd make is that I really think, again, from a European standpoint, that there should be an EU-Arab science summit in the fullness of time. I think we have strong articulation between Europe and Africa, and Europe and Latin America, and Europe. But I think there's a great opportunities on what I would call the Arab Europe line of engagement. So with that, again, Josef, congratulations to you on such a comprehensive, wonderful meeting. I'd encourage everybody following this meeting, because I see it as a process, to come forward out of this meeting with a very strong statement to the United Nations General Assembly, one which I would humbly suggest can form the basis of this meeting in September next year. We came to the organization of these sessions very late, only really in August. So I appreciate all your efforts to make it happen, given the short notice, but we have now a year's notice for next year. So we need to keep the dialogue moving. We need to keep the engagement going, and we need to create a much stronger base for science, in particular in relation to collaborative research and development at the level of the United Nations. So, Josef, congratulations again. I look forward to staying in touch.
Thank you. Thank you really very much, Declan, for supporting and facilitating this for us. But I think we need maybe need more than 3 hours to finish our Is it open or it will close at?
No, it's open.
That's good. Thank you for your interview.